Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to fix headphones that aren't detected on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. We have a few different things to try, so hopefully one of them will work. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. We'll begin by focusing on the connection of our headphones or earphones to our PC or laptop. A common cause for headphones not being detected is because they are connected to the wrong port. Check that you are not using the microphone port by accident. If you use USB, then make sure the port is compatible, such as with USB 2 and 3, although this is unlikely to be an issue. I would recommend trying as many ports as possible if you can, in order to rule out this being the cause. Also ensure that the device is fully inserted into the port, and that the port or connectors aren't broken or blocked by dust or debris. There should be plenty of ports on the back of your PC to try. The next thing to do is try your headphones on another device if you can, such as a different PC or your phone. This will help rule out that the issue is with the headphones. If your headphones don't work on a separate device, it's likely that there is physical damage. If your headphones work normally on your other device, then the problem is likely caused by something within Windows, so that's what we'll focus on next. In Windows 11, we will first check that our headphones are enabled or allowed. This can prevent them from being detected as an output device. There are two ways to do this, and it might be worth trying both. First, head to the main settings page. You can get there a number of ways, but we'll be searching for it in the search bar. In the settings, go to the system settings from the options on the left, although you should be already in here by default. In the system settings, click on the option called sound. Within the sound settings, find the section called output. It should be right at the top. Under here, it should say something like choose where to play sound. Below this, you should see the list of headphones or sound output devices connected to your PC. If you have multiple, select the one you want to use by checking the box to the left of its name. If you don't see your device here, scroll down and click on all sound devices. Now find your device from the output section, click on it, and then choose allow on the next page. It should now appear back in the output section of the main sound settings page. The second way to do this is the traditional method via the control panel. You can get there by searching for it in the search bar. In the control panel, click on hardware and sound. Now click on sound and it should open a separate window. In the new window, first go to the playback tab. You should see all of the headphones, speakers, and other output devices in here. If you don't see your device in here, right click on an option and choose show disabled and show disconnected devices. To enable your headphones in here, right-click on them, and then click on Enable. You can set it as the default sound output device in here too, with the button at the bottom of the window. Remember that your headphones might have a generic name, such as Realtek High Definition Audio, so it might be worth trying all of the possible output devices in case one of them is your headphones. The next method is to try running the troubleshooter to try and see if Windows can find any possible problems with sound or our headphones. To do this, go to the main settings page by searching for it, and then in the settings, click on system from the options on the left side, but again, you should be in here by default. In the system settings, click on troubleshoot, and then on the next page, choose other troubleshooters. Now click on run next to the playing audio troubleshooter, and try choosing a device that could be your headphones. Next, think back to when the issue started appearing. There is a chance that a software change or hardware change caused the problem. This could be some new audio software, or a new component. If you are certain that one of these changes caused the problem, then you could revert them or research how this will have affected your device and what you can do to work around it. Moving on, I would recommend making sure that your headphones don't need any additional setup in order to work correctly. Some headphones might need software, such as drivers from the manufacturer's website. Other headphones could need a power supply or a different connection type. All of this information should be on the manufacturer's website, so have a look on there to make sure you aren't missing anything. The next method will be to try reinstalling some of the sound drivers on your PC. Only do this if you are confident in uninstalling and reinstalling drivers. To do this, head to the device manager by searching for it, and then scroll down and look for either audio inputs and outputs or sound and video game controllers. Expand these sections by double-clicking on them and look for your device in here. If you see it, right-click on it, and then choose Uninstall Device. You now need to restart your PC or reconnect your device. Also, try updating the drivers for your devices. To do this, right-click on it and select Update Driver, then the Automatic option. stay in here for the next method. The final method is to manually update your Realtek audio drivers. There are two ways to do this, and I have a separate video that will cover how to do this in detail, so click the card on screen now to watch that. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. If you think the problem is physical with your headphones or connections, then check the warranty or for repair options. As always, I will keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows PC. Help support the channel by visiting the store. The link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.